Thank you. In their communities is often as high as 29%. With no public transportation available, they're forced to hitchhike along this road to have their shares. Lucy Dream is an advocate and works with Aboriginal youth justice. She thinks that mainstream society doesn't care about the Muslim women because they are neutral. Her own sister when Muslim women were found in 1990. Everything was going right for the daughter woman. She was popular in high school. She had a job at the local bank and had just been offered a summer internship at the local community center when she went missing.
Just peaceful stillness. I think they had a
figured that happened already.
Thank you.
dress. There's that feeling of what did that actually reveal? Investigators been able to answer all your questions since Ramona's body was found?
They have not given me any specific information that would satisfy me at all. There's a lot of questions that I've asked them and this is the case to not speak. It's still under investigation and it feels like for me it's just I have no right to know.
Dr. Dow has become an advocate for the Muslim girls in Ohio 16. She meets with community members on a regular basis to raise awareness about the dangers of hitchhiking. Dr. Dow has been working with Dr. Dow for the Industrial Fellow, a local artist who put together a lot of information about the missing women.
Falling silently. My heart is heavy and burdened, smothered with a grief so hard to bear. Please return to me and let me gently touch your cheek, if only in my dreams.
Women have always been missing, and it is definitely unbelievable racism. I think it's an issue of women who can't afford to drive, women who want to get from point A to point B, and how you get there if you don't have a car, how you get out of even a bad situation if you don't have a car.
I had some questions asked to me, but if Ramona had brown hair and blue eyes, would they solve her murder right away, or, you know? And sometimes my answer would be yes, they probably would solve it, you know. They probably would get to the bottom of it right away, because this is a small community, and all they have to do is ask some questions to different people, and it would be solved. And this has been 12 years for my daughter now.
As the number of women missing along the highway increases, the pressure on the Royal Canadian Mounted Police grows. Their local office in Prince George is no longer authorized to give any statements. So the head office in Vancouver moves on questions and met with staff sergeant John Ward. Why are these cases along Highway 16 so difficult to solve? This spring, Mary and Lena's families were among those who walked along the highway to